Hello everybody, and welcome to another Keen Stream. I'm joined today by Jesse Ball, community manager here at Keen Software House. So maybe Jesse, right away, because you've never been on camera before, maybe you could introduce yourself to the stream. I'm sorry, didn't know, but I'm not important. He's the main guy here, so.
No. It's been big shoes to fill. I guess it's been 6 months since I've been at Keen Software House in Prague.
Hold on, man.
Oh.
What's wrong, guys?
Is the sound working?
If I just mute, what's going on?
Oh, God.
Is it okay now? We're okay?
Audio is weird.
Shoot, Jesse.
Please.
Audio effects for the win, right? I just thought we'd start the stream a little bit of fun. I thought I'd go for my deeper voice. So let's start that again. Hi, everybody. Welcome to another Keen Stream. And I'm Zockley, and I'm joined by Jesse Ball, a community manager here at Keen Software House.
Hello.
And maybe, Jesse, you can give a little intro, because it's your first time on stream before, so, yeah.
Yeah, no, it's awesome to be here. I've been wanting to do it for a while. It just hasn't quite worked out until then. As far as the format of today's stream goes, what we're thinking of doing is going over Marek's recent blog post, because we're sure there's a lot of questions and feedback that a lot of people have already, which is awesome. And then at the same time, Joel here is going to be actually playing the game and showcasing some of the cool stuff that's going to be available during the public test, which starts tomorrow. And I just wanted to quickly add to, like, kind of on a personal note, I've been with Keen Software House now for technically going on 9 months, several of which were in Canada before I moved here. Those first 2-3 months were a lot of fun trying to, you know, get the lay of the land and to communicate with the team internally, and then to get to know you all and communicate with everybody externally. But it's been a lot of fun. I've learned a lot, and it's awesome to finally be on stream.
I mean, like, I was gonna say. I mean, like, it's an interesting thing, kind of learning the space engineers community, right?
Yes.
Because I mean, I've been now like a part of it for like 5 years, so. Yeah, it's an interesting ride, but there's a lot to take in and learn about a
definitely.
Very passionate community,
yes.
Very dedicated community.
Yes, definitely.
So I'm sure you've had some interesting things to learn, right? So
absolutely. Yeah. Why don't we, if without further ado, we can get started. Go ahead.
I was just saying, the main thing is that everything that you see today, you'll be able to play tomorrow at 11 a.m. Right? So it's like, what's that? Like, how many hours is that?
Oh gosh, math.
16 hours. Yeah. 16 hours. You'll be able to play everything yourself, okay? And we're going to need your help. This is the whole point. I mean, I think some people, based off the teasers and based off stuff that Marek was saying, people are expecting a release. But actually, no, what we actually need is to test this stuff thoroughly, because there are a lot of changes.
Yes.
So we want to get your feedback, and we want to get your bugs and crashes and all the rest of it. So that's why it's actually very important to do that. And that's also, we're going to be doing that for... Yeah,
also too, just for the official post, we said that it's from tomorrow starting at 10 a.m. UTC and going until Friday, January 18th, 4 p.m. UTC. But as you all know by now, sometimes we like to extend our public tests, into the weekend. So that could happen. But regardless of whether it does or it doesn't, we have two more public tests at the very least afterwards, if you're not able to make this one. And also too, of course, we'll be uploading this stream to our YouTube channel in case you know your friends weren't able to catch it or something like that. So
yeah, because this is a time for us to get feedback and hear a lot of stuff basically from you guys. One thing I want to quickly say is regarding the blog post, which we're going to go over and talk about, and I'm going to show off some of the stuff that's in it, is that I would just say right off that there are still some surprises.
Oh, yes.
Which will not be in this public test, right? So That's all I'll say. That's all I can say. You know, Marek's probably watching somewhere.
More teasing.
All I want, yeah, it's more teasing technically, but I just want to say is that, yes, there are still some surprises. But we'll leave it at that because there is still plenty to look at even in this update. So even in this test. So I think we just crack on.
Yeah, okay. That sounds good. So, just quickly starting with
you can
the...
budge over it, probably.
Oh, yeah.
The camera's a little bit...
Yeah, for sure. Get my big head in frame here. So starting off with the blog post, Space Engineers Public Test for the Major Overhaul of Survival. Hello, engineers. That's you guys. Welcome to Space Engineers in 2019. A lot of new and exciting things will come to light this year. We are starting the year with the STEAM Awards 2018, where Space Engineers was nominated for the Most Fun with Machine category. Our game was chosen out of 26,000 games on Steam. It's amazing how many games are on Steam.
We did really well there to get that.
So yeah. I'd like to say a big thank you to all of our fans for showing your appreciation. And again, while we're here, you know, a huge thank you to everybody who voted for us, who left a review, you know, to be considered not just out of 26,000 games on Steam, but with, you know, some of the other games like Factorio, which many of us are big fans of. With Rocket League, it's just awesome to be nominated. So thank you again. That's fantastic. Moving on, but more importantly, we are starting the year with the finalization of our next major release, the Survival Overhaul. The Survival Overhaul has been one of our top priorities, so it was specifically planned to be released after we had other key things finished. Over the last 6 years, we have carefully executed our original vision, which hasn't changed. Moving step by step forwards on our vision, the Survival Overhaul is one of those steps. In addition to survival, many new features have been designed to help new players to be introduced to the game and are not specifically focused on existing players. And just on that note too, I think that we have really been trying to balance bringing new exciting features to, you know, longstanding members of the community, and then also trying to help out those who are new to the game. And it's a delicate balancing act, I think. But it's been a lot of fun. we're just waving to the lead designer of Space Engineers' adorable little daughter who's by the window. Sorry, excuse me. Moving on, Survival Overhaul is one of the biggest overhauls because until now our main priority was making sure the sandbox elements work properly. We need to make sure that the physics are stable, multiplayer is reliable, the destruction is working, and so on. With this update, we are evolving from sandbox towards a game. This update is a real game changer. And I would agree with that just based on all the new things that we have added to Survival, especially the scenarios, which we'll get to.
Definitely, if you guys want to read this yourself, then there's a link in chat for this. And I do recommend going over it, because basically this summarizes what you guys are going to be testing and helping us get very important feedback on. So it really is, it really will help us, especially if you know what you're going to be looking at. So I'll start off right away just in the game here, and where did you get to in that? Okay, we can continue with that in a second,
I guess.
Yeah,
for sure.
So I make sure I don't forget anything, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
So first up, actually what you're seeing here is actually not, this is actually a test here. This is actually a local thing. You know how I like to, I actually mod my own backgrounds. This is something that will, you know, something like this will probably be happening, but hasn't been merged yet. This is just my local PC, but as you can see, there are some new videos there, so this is just something there. But if we go on to the new game screen, we are immediately welcomed by some new scenarios, the first of which is Learning to Survive. And basically, this will really help people to learn the game, learn how to survive, but I think it will also be good for, existing players will also be able to have some fun with it as well.
Absolutely.
Actually really nice design there. Aragaf has done a fantastic job with level design. There's like some old abandoned stuff to find and all the rest of it. So that's one of them. And then secondly, we have a scenario called Never Surrender, which is a survival world with high-end content. Challenge yourself by defending the beacon from hordes of drones. Prepare your defenses any way you like, play alone or together, how you do it is up to you. So basically you have a base, and you or with friends can choose how you defend against waves of enemies pretty much. So this is something that is like two new official scenarios here.
Also too, just on a side note, if you want to be cheeky during Never Surrender and attack your friends, you can.
There you go.
If you want to make it extra challenging.
So I think to start with, I'm trying to think which is the best way to do this, because obviously we have the features and we have the scenarios. What's the best way? I'm trying to think if we just jump into classic multiplayer, which is not...
I would say you have slightly more hours than me.
Yes, it's true.
I feel more streaming experience, so I will leave that up to you.
No, I think we'll start with how, if you join a multiplayer server, then you start right. Because the thing is great, but I think just to show off the new features, the best way is to jump straight into a standard world here. So I did already set one up. It was just called, it's just the easy star system. So if I click on this. It's great to see so many of you. Thank you so much for tuning in, guys. It's great to see you, and I'm really excited. We're really excited to see you get a hold of it tomorrow. So this is the new spawn screen, and actually, what you're actually greeted with is a faction selection to start with. So when you first join a server, you first get to join a faction. So you actually, it's good because it means you can spawn with your friends and all that kind of good stuff, which beforehand you had to spawn and then, you know, respawn all the rest of it. So normally, if you join a dedicated server, the very first thing that you see is a faction screen, which you can join. I think because it was a single player, it showed me the spawn screen first. But anyway, so let's say I just joined no faction, right? There's one other thing. Message of the day. So server admins can set a message of the day, which they can have rules and, all the message of the day. And that would normally appear in this space here. So the space to the left is for server admins to describe feature, all that kind of stuff for their server. But that's currently, you know, not there, and that can be toggled as well. So I'll join the no faction. And then I have the options here. And we see the new spawning options. So we've got Earthlight drop pod, Moon drop pod, Alien drop pod, Titan drop pod. And actually, it's not showing. It's just showing the actual vehicle you have here. So, is there something you wanted to add?
No. I was just admiring the different drop pods, the Titan.
Oh yeah, this is all stuff made by Aragath. So this is like the. This is like the parachute one,
yes,
which is on the Earth. The Moon, you're dropping in a similar parachute thing, but it's set to have wheels because the Moon is harder because you haven't got oxygen. You have to be careful about all that stuff.
True.
So that one is a wheeled one. That's the same. And then we have the new Space one, which is a cute little ship, and it's got a height, I haven't even said the name yet. It's got a,
Yeah.
I'm actually all over the place here. I'm so excited to see. I'm buzzing to show you guys this stuff, so I'm just, sorry if my mind is all over the place, but slow down. We're gonna start off with easy Earth-like drop pod, which is the first option on the list, and you'll see exactly how it starts. So, hold on, that's right. Respawn, take us there. So this is how it will start. You kind of wake up, you look around, you're falling. You look out and press V. There's a new block on the back. Right here, you'll see there's a new block, which we'll look at in a second.
Very pretty.
And as we come down, there goes the parachute.
Actually, yesterday, Joel was showing me a bug where the parachute was technically deploying, but it wasn't visible. That was interesting, but now that looks perfect, so that's great.
So here we are, landed safely, and this will auto-lock, so even if you land... I mean, I've had some pretty bad spawns before where I've landed and it's been on like a, you know, 45-degree angle or something like that, because basically these landing gears are set to auto-lock, so as soon as you hit the deck, it'll lock on. So you might get quite an unfortunate spawn, depending. Kind of on luck, I think. I noticed Aragath in chat, so we actually have our level designer and game designer in the chat, and I'm sure he'll be answering some questions as well, because he does know more, because he designed a lot of this stuff. So feel free, I mean, I've also, there might be some other developers in the chat, so definitely feel free to answer away, guys.
Also too, on that note, guys, you have questions for Aragath or anybody else and we don't get to answer them this evening, please message us on our support website or even hit me on Discord, Blitz333, and we'll do our best to get back to you as quickly as possible, even if that means having to ask somebody for an answer that we may or may not know. So,
just checking something a second. I just need to close some things. Okay, it's fine. Okay. One sec, guys. I just realized I buggered something up here. Okay. Should be fine. Okay.
Options, options, and the options.
Right. So on the back, we have a new block, the Survival Kit. And yes, the Survival Kit is a small grid block. And the Survival Kit, which is nicely tucked in here, this allows you to respawn at a small grid. So for example, right away, oh, I'm so excited to space engineers, whatever, and I'm just flying around, I'm so excited, I've just got this game, and you know, I'm famous for flying fantastically, so this would never happen. But here we go, oops, you know, I've died. So what happens is, oh no, I'm not dead. Sorry, I'm not dead, all right, it's all right, I thought
die
I was
again.
Dead. All right, yeah, so, and also you guys will be noticing the new trees. We have brand new trees in Space Engineers. Way more variants in there now. So I think the foliage looks much, much better now. And you get varying density of plants as well in different areas. So we'll see that.
Shout out to all the artists who worked on that.
There we go, now I'm dead.
Hey!
So what will happen is now, is boom.
Ah.
I pop out. Right back here, automatically, right back at my pod. So, that's just showing that. What I can do is here, just so you guys can see it, if we get the survival kit out, I will show you guys it, what it looks like kind of in the, hold on, outside of the thing. Oh, no, we're gonna hack some things here so you guys can look at the block. So we're now switching to creative real quick, but that's, there we go. So this is the survival kit for small grid.
Looks good.
Got some various valves and some shenanigans on there. Can link it up to the conveyor system. Got two small ports in the back, and we have one large port on that side. You can see it's offline there, but it's a really nice model done by our art team here. And the little health symbol kind of symbols that it is a respawn, like the med bay. So, there we go. So that's tucked in there very nicely there. I've got an extreme FOV here, guys. Let me help you out and go back to standard here, which is standard 70s. This should be a more pleasant viewing experience, right? Hold on. Well, guys, we'll get to questions in a little bit, okay? Because I know there's a lot of questions. So I'll try and show off the features and stuff, and then we'll try and, I mean, if Jesse sees something he wants to answer, then go ahead. But
for sure,
we'll try and demonstrate everything or most things first. But we can't share everything tonight because obviously to get to all the things, it's almost like we need to play survival. And obviously survival is a longer game, so we're not going to stream so long tonight. But right. And I'll explain how it works. So we have the survival kit. It's got a mass, and it's got an inventory. And if you go to production here, how it works is I can put in stone. And what happens is, if I get out my drill, straight away, I can start drilling. Now, I can pick up this stone, and even there's actually new, I think there's new models for the actual debris here as well. The debris are now higher quality model here, even the little chunks, right? So I've got some, a bit loud, sorry guys. I like to have it, you know, booming. Hear that fidelity, so I'll turn that down a little bit. And once I've got the stone, I put the stone into the survival kit, and then I go to production. And with that, I can click to make a mixed bag of ingots. Now what it works is, it basically, we've done it in a way that it takes stone and takes trace elements. So you'll get very, very small amounts of components here. So if I can build this, you can see. So I got some gravel, I got like a bit of iron, a bit of nickel, and a bit of silicon. With that, I can build new tools, but on the actual components, we're building blocks. There's a search bar there as well, you saw, there's a search bar, that's good. We've got limited components here. Computers, construction components, displays, girders, interior plates, steel plates, solar cells, and motors. Low-end stuff, essential stuff, you might say. Because what SE does have now is a sense of progression. You're not going to be able to start off right away and build a jump drive with a survival kit. The survival kit is not going to replace a a traditional refinery or a traditional assembler. It is purely for surviving. So it'll allow you to build some basic things from stone that you find and help you start off, right? So I think for the purpose of the stream, I'll probably fast forward the steps a little bit here to show you like how that might look, right? So we have three tiers. We have the starting thing, which is the survival kit, which is basically a built-in refinery and assembler. You've got the refinery thing and you've got the assembling thing. The next thing that we have, the next kind of stage, if you're on the G screen here, you can see some new blocks. We have the hydrogen engine, the wind turbine, and the small battery, and of course the survival kit. But we also have a basic assembler. So this is the middle ground between the survival kit and the classic assembler. Mm-hmm. Once again, this assembler cannot build everything, so you're not going to be able to build jump drives and high-end blocks with the basic assembler. What I will quickly say, because I know this might be a concern for maybe some more experienced players, is that this is an option. If you don't want to have this be restricted like this and have these blocks locked off, then in the world settings you can disable this. So for maybe some experienced players will just want to have everything available from the start in survival. It is an option, okay? So you can see here, for example, if I want to build the medical room, to unlock the medical room, I have to build the basic assembler. What else have we got here? To build the battery, basic assembler. But then if I go down here, look at some of the higher end stuff, the jump drive, I need to build an antenna. To build a gravity generator, I need a battery, a small battery and an assembler. So different blocks have different things to get to that stage, right? And this, as we know that some people will want to have the total freedom to start with, then they can have that, right? It is totally optional. But I do think that it will be good for both new and also returning players who haven't played the game for a long time to slowly ease their way into all the blocks. Because I know these days there's so many blocks in SE, you open it up and you think, oh God, what do all these things do? So I think it starts off with the essential blocks, and then as soon as you start building these, you can build a rover, then you can build an atmospheric ship, then you can build a ship to space, and then you can build, you know, all the, and so on, right? So it kind of introduces blocks as it goes in importance for survival. So yeah, I'm rambling a lot here because there's so much to get through. So apologies for me just, you know, getting it all out there. And I do see so many questions, so many things
been
in chat.
A few of them.
But it's yeah, I know. I'm on a roll here, you know. I'm trying to keep momentum up on the explaining thing. So yeah. Anything you want to add, Jesse?
I was just gonna say, like I said before, I think with like this update, we're really trying to, you know, add new features that, you know, perhaps we might have teased before, you know, a while back, you know, hashtag wind turbine, you know, the hydrogen engine, but also to adding things that people hadn't seen before, but also, again, trying to strike that balance between, like, some new cool features for existing, you know, hardcore players, and those, like, as Joel said, returning the game and or, you know, just starting the game for the first time. It's pretty cool.
I actually have to do something for a second to explain one of the new mechanics. I am hiding one of the new mechanics, and that is temperature. So some eagle-eyed people spotted that in one of the teasers that we put out. So if I, still loud, is it? That drill was really loud, eh? Okay, let me turn this down then. Way down. So what I'll show is, I'll hide us for a second, because otherwise we're gonna be in the way. So we'll go full game. Right, oh, no, that's the wrong one. That's the game. here we go. So, I can't even point at it, but if you look at the bottom right, next to the oxygen, we have the temperature. Now, a couple of things about this. I'll try and explain it. Your suit does have a heater, does have air conditioning, so your suit is actually keeping your body at a good temperature, right? But if you're in extreme cold, in the night for example, then you'll burn energy quicker because your suit is working harder to keep your body temperature at an optimum level, right? So as soon as your energy drops to zero, you will start to die from cold if you're in a cold place. Likewise, if you go to the, this is gonna be an interesting one, if you go to the center of a planet, for example, the center of a planet is very hot. So if you get to the center of a planet, it's gonna be very hot and your suit is gonna be going into overdrive to keep your suit cold and air conditioned, right? Or, you know, at a good temperature. So once again, if you're in a hot environment in the center of a planet or getting pretty deep down, your suit will start to use energy quicker. But if you run out of energy, your suit cannot air condition your suit any longer, and then you'll start to die. So it'll start to take damage, right? Now, one thing to avoid this, if you're in a pressurized grid, you will not feel the effects of temperature. So if you have a pressurized ship going down to the center of the planet, I guess you'll be okay. Or if you have like a little outpost in the Arctic and the night comes, you can go in there and you don't have to worry about energy or anything. Pressurized spaces will keep you at an optimum temperature. So that's one of the new things there. I don't think, Aragath, did I miss anything? I know Aragath was probably, you can see right now I'm warm, but I guess if I use some tricks here, I guess I could show you guys. If I turn on creative mode, I could quickly go to the center of the planet, but. All right, we're back. So pretty close for now. Okay, so apparently I got most of things there. That's the main thing. I'm trying to see if there's anything to, quick questions I'll try and answer on as we go. Do pressurized places include cockpits? I believe so, Adron. Yes. I believe so, yes. I think, I'm not sure if cockpits have to be conveyed up without oxygen for that to be included. I'm not actually sure.
That's a good point.
You can get to the center of planets. Yeah, you can get. Any more questions regarding the temperature, guys? Ask away, guys, because I'll try and do it now on part. So, what about the ship? No temperature effect. Not on the grid itself. It's an astronaut based, engineer based thing here. Temperature, good thing. Does temperature depend on day and night? Yes, Atomic Junkie. So if you're in the night, if you just stand out in the whole night, there's a possibility you'll die from cold, pretty much. If it's a colder place, I think.
Yeah. Just to jump into MLG Boss Steam 6. Is there now random encounters? Please, because it would make the game more alive. Yes, there is. Like we said earlier, if you're just joining us. There's a lot of freedom within that new scenario, how you want to go about defending your base or bases, if you want to play by yourself, if you want to play with friends. And as I mentioned before, if you want to be a bit cheeky, you could perhaps attack your friend who's being attacked by drones as well. So, yes, there is a new scenario.
And there is some really awesome... Now, Aragath in chat, again, he actually was making the encounters.
Yes.
And there's some really, really cool things to be found out there. There's a lot, I'm not sure if Aragath, anything you want to kind of hint at people, or should we leave it for them to discover themselves, Aragath? But there is a lot of really cool things, like I would say like the level design quality of the encounters that you'll come across and find it's beautiful, it really is. So that's gonna be something interesting if you discover out in space, right? Right. Let me see if I can get through the other things here. So I was gonna play a little bit of this. So I've taken some resources here. Hold on, no, I haven't. And I need to, no, I need to put them back in, sorry. Put them back into the survival kit. And then with that, I'm going to build some components. What do I need here? More iron, hold on, let's go get some more stuff then. Is it too loud, guys? How are we looking now? And Jesse, maybe while I do this, you can try and answer some of the questions.
Yeah, exactly. I was just actually getting back to...
I'll try and play a bit of the survival here and show you what the new survival start might look like.
Sounds good. Okay. Some beds. Will there be planetary encounters? Yes. Well, just because for the new scenario, I believe also it starts on the planet. So, yes. Lots of questions here. Snow Raider, just going back up here. What about the cargo exploration ship encounters? Was that system revamped at all? Yes, if you go through the blog, we do mention that that has been revamped. We have tweaked it a bit, so that is a yes. Love all the questions, but there's lots.
Give me a start, apparently. It's dark out here. Well, I might try and also find some...
Actually, that's a good question with regards to Joel. You might be able to answer that one. I'm trying to find it again. some form of batteries to be used, like O2 and H2 bottles. That's a, do you know what they mean by that?
Sorry, what?
Some form of energy to be used, like the O2 and H2 bottles.
Oh, I think it's meaning about batteries for your suit. That's not there.
But yeah, I was just going to say then, yeah, no, that is not there. I thought that's what they might have meant, but... Okay. What about spiders and wolves? Marson 788PL. I know that we have been trying to squash, as were some of those bugs with regards to the spiders and wolves. So we'll probably have more details about that for the actual update itself. Because there are lots of, for instance, like bug fixes, performance optimizations for single and multiplayer, etc.
I'm actually going to leave this suit here because I want to show off some of the other starts as well.
Yeah,
so,
sure.
Again, this is what like an Earth-like start might look like again. So you're going to be going from the survival kit, which is basic blocks, then to the basic assembler, which I'll also hop in here.
Also, too, this is a good question. Jakea underscore official, sorry if I'm mispronouncing your name, is wind real or faked? In the sense of, are we adding a lot of weather effects with this update that actually affect the environment? As of right now, no. But obviously the wind turbine is working. I'd also like to stress too that, you know, just because something isn't in this public test or perhaps even the eventual survival overhaul, it doesn't mean that it's off the table for us considering to add in the game eventually. As Joel and I said earlier, we really want these public tests to serve as getting as much feedback as we can. So, yeah.
So on the screen right now, guys, you're looking at the second tier. So this is where you'll progress to after the survival kit. So the first thing will be about getting a basic assembler built and a basic refinery. So the Arc Furnace, or actually, it's had so many names in the past.
Yeah, I was just going to say.
That block is now the basic refinery, okay?
Yes.
I think it's had some upgrades as well, graphically. The basic assembler here, you can see there's a nice glass panel on the side. It's a one block assembler. So that's that. And as you can see again in this, you haven't got stuff like superconductor components. So again, some still more high-end blocks are not there. But I think added on, we now have like magazines, we have power cells, radio communication components. These are all things that are a part of the basic assembly assembler, but not a part of the survival kit. And the refinery, yes, I remember now. The basic refinery allows you to also disassemble stuff. If you go back to the production here, all we have for the survival kit is the ability to create ingots from like the trace elements of the stone, right? There's nothing else. So as soon as you get to the basic refinery, you can start doing some... we were still on the wrong screen there. My bad. Wait a minute. No, sorry. I was talking about the assembler. yes, I think it's what it takes. So there's that. And if I just quickly get here to show quickly the kind of tier system. Yeah, my bad. I'm going to show you the hydrogen engine in just a second because the hydrogen engine actually features in the space start. So if I'll show you this, let me get the standard assembly. I mean, I don't know if you guys know this blog, but just so you can kind of see where I'll get the, hold on. So we've got, hold on a minute. This is the large grid survival kit. So you have a survival kit that you can also build for the large grid, which we did a teaser for. So we have the large grid one and we have the small grid one, which I'll just plop down here like so. There we go. Oh no, well, sorry, my bad. Wait, that's the large grid one still. Oh, there we go. There's a small grid one. So again, the survival kit can be conveyed up from both sides and on the large grid. I'm trying to think of any difference. I think it works exactly the same as the small block. The small block survival kit and the large block are identical, right? And finally, I just wanted to whip this in as well, just for kind of showing what, you know, what it all looks like. Something going on here, I see. There's something with the blocks. I'm trying to figure out what that is. It obviously, it's just like they're not actually connecting there. But yeah, this is it. So you're going from the survival kit, basic assembler, basic refinery, smaller space, and then finally the big boys, which you are well familiar with, which have all the high-end stuff. You can see here, we've got the reactor components, the thruster components, the superconductors. I can't actually quite tell what else has been added there, but you can kind of see there's probably about nearly a row and a half is added for every new one. Right, so that's the kind of the new process of going when it comes to refining and assembling. What I'm gonna do now is go back and disable this lander so I can respawn, because I think here, if I just get in here and do the battery, turn the battery off, if I respawn.
I am just trying to answer as many questions as I can while you're speaking about all these cool features. So.
Are you, okay, yeah.
Yeah, just while you're talking, okay. Just so I can try and answer.
So let's go to the space respawn. I love this spawn because the ship that Aragath's built for it is so cool. It's compact. And, you know, like, long gone are the days of the yellow respawn ships. We come here, and as soon as we get into this space start, we've got the large grid survival kit right by our side here. We can keep the pressurization going. And we have this little balcony here that we can stand on, and I've been doing this in multiplayer where people have been riding in this little balcony as I've been driving. We've got a cargo container back here, and up here we have the hydrogen engine, which
we may have teased a while ago, and it's now finally here.
Yes. So this looks, the way that this is built into the build here, you can see this little ship, and this takes ice and converts ice into power. Pretty much you insert ice and you get It's a way, it's not going to give a load of power, because a reactor is still going to be the ultimate way to power your big ships. But for starting out, it's a good way to actually get energy here. I'm trying to see if there's any point to this ship. This ship is almost as small as it could be. I mean, there's some things, it could have had one thrust in each direction, but I feel like it's compact enough to look quite cool, but it's not as big as the yellow ship, right? So we've got like three thrusters going forwards, some decorative blocks in there a little bit. We've got the thrusters, we've got the hydrogen engine, we have an oxygen tank, and the cockpit. I mean, I think the front of it kind of harks back to the original respawn ship. Style kind of bridge there. But it's a cute little thing, and another one that's made by Aragath. Well, there was some debate about the name, Rivian. I'm not quite sure if this is the final thing for it. I knew there was some internal discussion about it, and it's actually bounced around quite a lot. So I'm not sure if Aragath has anything more to say on that one. So
we have some interesting debates regarding names. It gets challenging after you have...
Yeah, you were helping out with that as
after,
well.
After you have so many blocks, because you, on the one hand, you want it to make sense from like... a real-world scientific, you know, astronomy point of view, but we also have to try and make it make sense, for lack of a better phrase, in the game with regards to all the other naming conventions we already established. So it's interesting.
Yeah.
Jakai underscore official, Keen Community Network.
Battle Sparrow.
Does that mean uranium will be easier? Or pardon me, I'm just again so many questions.
Well,
here.
I think the way that it's been balanced, because that's the thing, you know, Aragath, a lot of it, and our designers have been working to balance the game and try and defer like what is more high end and what is harder to do but is better and efficient.
True.
And what is easier but less efficient. And the way I know, I think uranium is more of, it's not like end game, but it's more something to strive towards, because it is going to give you a lot of power, right?
Yeah.
So here we go. And this is what a space start might look like. You find an asteroid field and you begin mining. You can take the rock, of course, and use the survival kit. But of course, in space, it's easier to find ores as well. So that's going to be kind of a benefit for you being in space, right? So what I mean is the Dr. Casimo, I'm not sure, like, for example, I feel like Jump Drive is the ultimate endgame, if you see what I mean. The hydrogen engine provides more of an alternative playstyle for those who prefer low power hydrogen builds. So that kind of sums it up. It's basically, it does provide a different playstyle. And I think, of course, there's going to be some insane builds that use this. Aragaf, is this public? I think you could actually join me, Aragaf, if you wanted to, mate. We could actually get another person in the game here. So the new space spawn ship system looks need to read that one out. And what I'll do is
side note at Fancy Justice, you should really check out Sekhtan, one of our like long standing awesome modders for space engineers. He just released, I believe it was yesterday, a really cool VR experiment video. So, and before that, he well, not technically finished, but certainly hit like a major milestone for his moon project. So shout out to Sekhtan and still creating
definitely
awesome mods.
So I'm trying to quickly get, what I want to do is real quick is actually get some of the new blocks. You guys have seen them already, but I want to get them out laid out so you can see them as well, just in the flesh here. Obviously, I'm using a bit of creator mode here to, for the purpose of the stream, to show you the stuff. So let me get that engine up. So we have, here we have it. I reckon if I, actually if I make the game, okay, that's interesting now, okay. That's fine. And then I'll get the small grid variant as well. You can see how that looks like standalone.
Do you want to answer that question from Jill DePraz? Can the hydrogen engine use hydrogen as fuel and not just ice? We need clarification because you gave the impression it only uses ice.
Last time I checked from Aragaf, it only uses ice. Is that Aragaf? Can you just confirm that with us? Just double checking that.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's just ice as well, but.
Oh.
Only on hydrogen. Interesting.
My bad. I ran that round. So that was my bad. So I got it the other way around. So that was good on my part. So sorry. Back up. Backtrack. The hydrogen engine. It's called. It only runs on hydrogen. It does not use ice. Okay.
Sorry guys.
So sorry. Yeah. Sorry. I'm just so excited. I'm making mistakes. So yeah. Unless yeah. So this will fit in really nicely to builds, I think. This will go in really nicely to the small grid build as well. What I'll do is here is wait. Thank God that makes much more sense. Okay, yeah, sorry for that, guys.
Apologies.
Yeah, apologies. Yeah, I'm sorry about that.
There's just lots of questions and lots of new stuff.
Yeah, I'm kind of overwhelmed still. I'm trying to think of all the things I need to show. We've talked about the temperature system.
Did you talk about, we did small battery.
Small batteries.
Battery.
Yeah.
And also too, just for the record, we...
What I should do is back up, save this and back up and go to Creator World so I can actually show the...
I was just going to say, I know another heavily requested feature is a small window book. And we know, and we're still committed to adding new blocks to the game, so it's not like that is not on the table. So, but the small batteries are very cool. But I get a ton of messages about the small window. Oh, hey.
So now in creator mode, you can see this thing buzzing away here. It's nice to see an animated block in SE. I've got a fan on the end here. You see it all working away. It's pretty beautiful to see that working though, I must admit. There we go. And you can color it. Yeah, good point. It's you can tell. Let me just give it a nice red. There we go. And there's a lot of things to do in modding as well. So there's this. We're going over the obvious features here.
The visual scripting tool.
Yes,
well.
There's a lot of things under the hood. There's optimizations. Maybe I'm not sure if you want to refer back to the blog post to make sure we haven't missed anything. Because obviously the shiny stuff is the new blocks and it's the things that you
Also too, LCD. Yeah, we haven't showed off the LCD.
Inside.
Yeah.
Of course, we have this new thing now that when you get into a ship, it's already on, I think. Yeah, so when you boot up a ship, you hit Y, everything comes to life. So
it's a nice little feature. Just going back to like the Visual Script tool, there's new icons and a lot more like features that are designed to try and be a little more user-friendly. With the visual scripting tool, players can create their own scenarios, their own appealing goals, and share them on the Steam Workshop, but many of you already know that. I'm trying to think of what else. We did mention cargo ships and encounters.
Well, I'm going to now actually, I'm all over, yeah, small batteries what I wanted to show.
Yeah, I was just going to say, you should definitely show that.
So I'm going to get a little thing up. I'm going to get my old bud up here. It's my old bud, Zogbot. Trusty servant, right? This would be a good example to show maybe use these new blocks. So we get the batteries out, and I'm super excited for these because the kind of things you can do with this in compact builds. Because the problem is now, when you have a small reactor, you have to make sure they're all conveyed up. So having a small battery means you just have to plug a grid in to charge it, or just have one accessible reactor to charge it, right? So you can see we've got these new guys here. These are half blocks. I need to delete these a second. Maybe I can try and...
Just another reminder too, guys, we're trying to answer as many questions as possible, but please do not hesitate to contact me on Discord. It's blitz3333, and then also too on our support site. Always happy to try and answer questions, or anywhere else on our social media, even if it's YouTube or Facebook. So again, apologies if we don't get to your questions here.
So we saw this as well, and you can see this coming online here, how the emissive works. I think for building drones, building smaller builds, this is going to be really, really exciting. I know there's creators or builders have already been expressing their excitement for this. So I think missiles and all that stuff.
Aaron, I think Aaron and the Last 10 Gamers and the Drone Army might have some interesting things, some interesting creations.
With these batteries.
Yes, yes.
Okay.
Like,
what I might, I'm going to show off the new scenarios as well, guys, briefly, so you can have a look at the new scenarios, which you'll have to play tomorrow. just another reminder as well for people who are still joining. I said it at the start because I have seen some questions about it. That yes, these are things that are going in the test tomorrow for you guys, but there are still some surprises which have not been revealed yet. So. Yes, that's just worth mentioning that, even though the test is tomorrow and you'll have this to play with, there is, there's still some things to be seen.
Also too, again, just if you're joining us, we realize that not everybody can participate in the test tomorrow and Friday, but in the past we have often extended our public test, so that's a possibility, and we're planning to have two more tests minimum. So we're really hoping that everyone will get the chance to at least participate in one of those. And thank you in advance for all of the feedback, which you'll be able to submit via survey, as always, at the end of the test.
So I'm going to quickly back out now and go back to the new game screen.
Also, too, just speaking of surveys, at the end of the test period for the public test on Thursday and Friday, with regards to the Keen Software House development survey, again, just if you didn't know, we had over 5,000 people who submitted surveys to us, and we really, really appreciate that because we got a ton of useful information, and we'll also be having more surveys this year as well. So just something else to keep in mind because, again, yes, we have our own design philosophies, but we definitely love to hear what you guys want in the game. It definitely informs what we do as developers. So.
So I was just showcasing here, this is the new learning to survive scenario, right?
Yep.
So it's a brand new survival to start off. And I think it would be nice for some experienced players to go through it because there's some really cool level design stuff to find. But I guess it will definitely be helpful for people who maybe aren't so good at survival or are learning the game for the first time because we have good bot here. and it's telling us to do some tasks. So right away, there are small tasks for you to perform. These tasks will be activated by finding and activating specific bundle panels. There are several such bundle panels on this platform. So we have a choice where to go for. Like, do we want to learn about the survival kit? Do we want to learn about oxygen and hydrogen? Solar panels up there. There's the ship, which we have the start. That we've seen before. So for example, if I hit the survival kit here, it's injured me on purpose, but it's like, okay, the survival kit can refine ores, produce basic components, and allow you to recharge your energy and health, and then press F on this screen to recharge your energy and health.
I just have to read this. What code again, if I'm pronouncing your name wrong. Can we shoot good.bot yet? No. And we've also received a lot of feedback with regards to being able to turn off good.bot. We realized off the bat that for veteran players that they may or may not find good.bot very useful. But again, we're trying to strike that balance to newcomers to the game and just being able to try and teach them much about the game as soon as possible without holding their hand too much and trying to stay true to a sandbox game. So I just thought I'd mention that.
So I now have to use this to, I need to quickly repair this up here.
Captain Jack, can we get good.bot to follow us around like the 343 Guilty Spark? He was annoying. Yeah, that, you know, I have to admit, that would be cool.
So I've repaired the conveyor system here as well to get the oxygen flowing there.
Okay,
so I
cool.
can do this. And it's not just a tutorial island. There's actually more to find in this world. This is another thing made by Aragaf here. So replenish your oxygen. You need to a working conveyor between. So I fixed that already, I think. So now I need to go back here. And I've already repaired, I kind of skipped it here. So I've repaired it. And I've done that oxygen hydrogen mission. So this is some key things to get you started in survival. There's this here, I need to repair this solar panel here, and that will be part of that. But what I do is if I go down to the ship, come down, we have, okay, right, first, let's do this. So this is the ship task. This ship seems to be locked to the platform. So turn off the landing gear and use a grinder to disable it, or use a grinder to disable it. So I will switch the lock, and now the ship is mine to fly. So once I'm inside it, there's actually things to discover in this map, including, So you can see I've got mining outpost, which is the task ship mining, which is teaching you about mining. We have ship tools, construction facility, and another asteroid. So basically, in this asteroid cluster, we have all kinds of little missions to help you get started. So this is, what's nice about this, because we had the campaign in the past, which taught you some, it taught you controls, it taught you some elements of the game.
Quite basic though,
but this,
we admit.
Yeah, exactly. It was more about the kind of, it was more story based.
Yes, yeah.
It was less about what you find in SE. What's nice about this, it's like a standard scenario, well, it's like a survival scenario, but it's kind of holding your hand through the first steps because, again, you might not know all the things, right? So,
I just also want to point out to you guys, like, for instance, I see here Discord messages for people who've DM'd me directly on Discord. Xficer, I'm going to game end you, all these people. So I just want to let you know that I do see them, and I will definitely get back to you sometime after the stream, probably first thing tomorrow morning. So thank you. Thank you.
That's what I wanted to find. So, for example, here's something. I don't want to show too much because, again, you guys can kind of play it yourself. But, for example, I want to highlight this because it's a really nice bit of level design from Aragaf here. So, for example, here is a... I'm fast-forwarding a bit here, but I'm just showing a little bit, and then I'll leave the rest of it for this to be discovered. So here is a an abandoned kind of hangar here, which is all knocked up. You can kind of see it's the hangar doors are frozen, but in this you'll find a ship. And then that will be a part of the mission to repair things. So it's quite cool because like that's tucked away in this little asteroid here, built in, there's stuff to be repaired. And of course, I think if you repair that survival kit that maybe you can even respawn here, right? So there's some really cool things to discover on this map. So it plays like a tutorial, but it also, I think, could be a nice start for everyone. And definitely, I recommend when you guys test it tomorrow, please do play it because there may be some issues, there may be some bugs. So we really need you guys to actually check this out for us, right? And Kianata, welcome. Some other people, welcome. How are you doing, guys? Fenlig, how are you doing? You can play this one. No, this one's single player only, actually, I believe. How you doing, Relic Say? Jimical, welcome. Climb.
Captain Jack.
A couple of shout outs to some people. There's so many. It's great to see so many of you here tonight, guys. Aragath is, I think, answering as many questions as he can.
Yes, yes.
I'm not, again, I can't answer all the, what we'll try, I'm trying to flick through everything that you'll be testing, because again, you guys will find that all out for tomorrow when you're discovering it. So I want to kind of highlight what we really want you to look at, and then I think we can then answer a bit more questions, because, yeah, there are things to discover. You can just see from that list of entities that I accidentally showed. I didn't mean to do that. I wanted to just find the construction hangar, because I wasn't sure where it was, but you can see there's actually plenty of stuff to find on this map. Aragath, how long do you think it will take to complete this tutorial if you do it from the start, right? Like, if you were to start this off, it seems like there's quite a lot of things hidden in asteroids all over the place. Because I've only got two signals right now.
While Aragath answers too, just again, some other under the hood stuff that Joel was alluding to before too. We have small updates to PCU changes, game chat, building changes, and a new voxel generation system that helps display voxels properly and make the LOD transition smoother. So again, we're trying to show you some of the bigger, flashier things, I suppose, like, you know, the wind turbine, the hydrogen engine, small batteries, those sorts of things. But there's also lots of stuff, as we said before, like under the hood. So
here we go.
Oh, okay.
Oh, you know what I love about this? Because this is OG SE right here.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah.
So, oh, damn.
Well done.
I just managed to take out all my... I blame... You nudged me. You nudged my chair.
To be fair, my knee is right there.
Yeah, you actually just accidentally nudged my hand, and I just... you know.
I'm sorry.
Damn it, Jesse. I thought I could trust you being on stream to be, you know... a good teammate.
Well, I have been mentioning how, like I said, I this is like the third time now I think I'm mentioning it. Like, teammates can't attack each other in these wave scenarios, so I might be that kind of teammate. But that was actually by mistake.
Oh, man. No, it wasn't.
It looks good, though. Like, that, it looks good, even though it's on fire.
And it's drifting now forever. Okay, anyway, let me go find where I was going to. That doesn't, if you're a good player, that doesn't happen to you. But anyway, I was just saying how great this level, I mean, it shows you how hazardous space can be, right? You fly too close to these little asteroids, little bits of rock floating around. So eventually you'll find yourself here, and another kind of like old base, because all the doors are kind of cracked, kind of frozen shut. And you've got a conveyor connector here. The actual door is damaged once again, so we can't get in here without fixing the door or going in the side. So this little area here is for teaching you guys, teaching about mining. I mean, in this hang, which is quite cool, we see like this slightly damaged mining ship. And all these ships are new as well. Like, everything you see is being made from scratch by Aragath. So, I mean, guys, if you like what you see, just, I would love to see some love in the chat for Aragath, because he's been working so hard on the level design and the encounters that you're kind of seeing at the moment. It's giving me those classic asteroid SE vibes, you know.
Yeah, it's pretty cool stuff. And then, you know, same with, you know, the artists and like the whole team for that matter. Like, they have been you know, very hard. But yes, Aragath has been.
Oh, look at this as well. There's like tunnels in here as well. Some like dugout tunnels. So this will be like your mining tutorial, and I guess if I click on this, it will tell me what to do. So here I've arrived. Start task. There is a useful mining ship here, but it needs to be repaired. Okay. So the nearby components are nearby. So let's see. There's a car container right here. I guess this is what I need. So I can. Oh, I've already got some stuff in my inventory.
Hey.
So I can come over to this. Restore power to the mining ship. So here we go. Batteries restored. There's another battery here to repair. And so power's back on. Enter the cockpit pressing F, and here I go. Select the drills and use. Find a way to escape with the mining ship.
That's a good question, Wakode. Can we pressurize asteroids now? I actually would have to. That looks really cool.
F? Oh, that's all right. I love the little flashing lights, Aragath, as well on the top. The subtle features, but Aragath is a master ship builder. There's we're incredibly lucky, like, to have kind of the kind of fidelity of shipbuilding on the team, because it really is legit stuff. So it says to find a way out of the mine. So I guess technically you could either.
You nudged me already. Sorry to interrupt.
Thank you, Moldark. Yeah.
Thank you.
So I guess you could do a couple of things here. You could either like drill your way out, or you could actually like ram the doors or repair the doors. I think the task was to find a way to escape, right? So I guess what does this require? Oh, okay, I looks like I have the components to fix the doors up, but that could also be an option now. So that's never another little task there. I can run out here. Let's see what else there is. Let's fly over to the ship building task. This is interesting. Wait, is that where I started? No, wait. Wait, no, I started. Oh, I see, because the range of it. So I could only see two places from when I first started out. But as I've gone further from the starting platform, more objectives are appearing. So over here, that's the construction platform. Or the other way, we had the ship tools as well. So yeah, and I'm not going to do all the stuff now, really. I will, because, you know, we said this was going to be a short stream, like 1 hour max, but already we're an hour in. There's so much to kind of talk about, and there's so much. Well, I think from our part, we just want to. We can't wait to get testing of you guys tomorrow.
Yeah,
like
exactly.
Getting actually people in multiplayer. You can bet that I'm going to be doing it tomorrow. I think worth pointing out that we're going to have a number of community streamers tomorrow, right?
Yeah, so
you want to mention?
Yeah, also too, I'll definitely be putting some posts out there, but Robin Shield, who I believe is in the chat, if you're still there, hello. Oh yeah, there you are. Cosmic Chimp, and possibly Epic Tech will be streaming for us, and they're going to be going over all the features that we're going over right now, and they're going to be streaming a lot longer than us, approximately anywhere between 3 to 5 hours, so if again, I'll post that across our social media, and if you can join us, that would be awesome. And they may or may not have free copy. They may or may not have copies of Space Engineers Deluxe, and some other cool stuff to give away. So keep that in mind.
I'm now going to jump back to the other.
Oh yeah.
New scenario, which is more for experienced players.
Definitely.
Which is the new thing, which is called
Never Surrender.
So. I'll also be streaming tomorrow as well, yeah, guys. So I will be going. I'll be organising some testing. So feel free to stop by my channel tomorrow. We'll be doing some intensive testing as well, and I'll also try and answer some more questions and concerns that people have as well. So if you want to stop by, that'll be awesome.
Fun fact: Never Surrender. The name for that was inspired by Winston Churchill's speech. Just
there
like throw
go.
It in there.
So I read it once again. This is a Overworld with high-end content. Challenge yourself by defending the beacon from hordes of drones. Prepare your defenses any way you like. Play alone or together. So this one you can play with friends. And we jump right in and you'll see exactly what it's about. And all the drones and all the enemy you see have been made by Aragath once again. So let me see here.
I just answered somebody was wondering when you were streaming. You'll probably be in the evening, right? Like 8 or 9 p.m. UTC? Probably. Or are you going to do it during the day? Or
You know what? Maybe I'll do it in the day.
Okay.
Maybe
cool.
Because it's... I don't know. I've got work to do, actually. But I'll see.
We both do. But I'll definitely put promote his channel as well. Just so if you want to check out his stream or Cosmic Chimp or Epic Tech or Robin Shields, by all means. Or all of them.
And you guys, if you don't know, you can find me over there tomorrow. I'll actually probably stream later tonight as well. I'll probably go home in a little bit and I'll do some stuff tonight as well. Not playing this, but we can talk about some more things. So, right. It's not what I expected, actually. It's actually, Aragath, it's actually changed just I'm interested here because I haven't actually played the new version of this. So let's see. Aragath, what do you recommend, man? Do you reckon, which for this Never Surrender, what place is the best place?
Oh, as far as the base, which one are you going to choose? I don't know.
I'm just wondering if he has a suggestion. Space start, roger that. Okay.
No one can hear you scream when you're nudged in space. Unless you're on Discord.
Because I played an earlier version of this scenario, so it's actually a little different to what I expected. So I'm not actually sure when everything starts coming about, but we'll see.
Uh,
So. How you doing, Razor? Good to see you, man. Welcome. It was good meeting you. Yeah, it's that was a good time. Good time indeed. Oh, here we go. We got a space base. Let's find out what this is. So, Goodbot's kind of leading us through this. I missed that. I forgot what he said. Hold on. I can check in here, right, though. No.
That's not working.
It should be, right?
It should be.
What did he say to me? He said something about, take your time, engineer.
Our lead, the lead game designer for Space Engineer said, if we notice any bugs, I'll write that down, actually. It's a good one to...
So we're gonna go to the space base and find out what's happening.
He probably said, "Watch out for Jesse's knee while you're flying next to asteroids."
Yes, probably, probably.
Chat history bug.
Oh, thank you. Move to one of the markers. Got it.
Thank you.
It's gonna take a little while here. Let's find out what it is. Because it said one of the markers, I assume that depending where you are, there is multiple markers. So just referring back to that post, Jesse, was
yes.
there anything else that we needed to...
I think we've covered it all, just because, again, like I mentioned, those under-the-hood things, like, you know, tweaking PCU changes, game chat. I think Udrakan just mentioned that in the chat, thank you. Building changes, new voxel generation system. You already went over the trees. Did we go over? Yeah, we did go over planetary and asteroid voxel feature or textures. Pardon me.
What I wanted to show is more of the trees because actually, trying to think back now, that's probably what I'll try and do in a second. Actually, is go back to the planet and show you guys some of the biomes look with the new foliage, right?
And also too, I'm sure there's some people here today that were commenting on the trees when we were teasing them that like those look like medieval trees or. You know, and if I'm being honest, at the time I had to clarify like what kind of improvements we're looking for the trees. But yes, the trees have definitely got some nice touches, as it were. So looking a lot better, I think.
What I quite like about this new starting ship design is the fact it's got this openness to it.
Yeah,
I think it's really cool having like this open deck, and I can kind of see the world going by. Right.
That is cool. Kind of reminds me going like if you've ever gone like a riverboat cruise and you have like the open parts.
Oh yeah.
It's if you've ever done that in Prague, for instance.
In Prague, indeed. Yeah. Hey Mawa, how you doing, man? So while we travel here, we've got a bit more time to try and answer some questions. Let me see what there is about visual scripting. So visual scripting is massive, and I'm so glad that it's been revisited because it means that our incredible, talented community can actually start pushing out some really good scenarios. So we've improved the visual script tool. I'm trying to remember what else. There's new icons and there's new features and it's more user friendly. So for you guys who like making scenarios and stuff like that, it's going to be really good. For example, all of the scenarios that we've made. So this scenario, which is obviously fighting back drone waves, and both the Never Surrender, the Survival scenario,
Learning to Survive,
were made with our tool. It's not like some in-house shenanigans or anything like that. So literally, we made the scenarios that you see now with the tool, which means that you can make just as good or better, you know what I mean? Which is, I think, I'm so excited. I can't wait because I know that we've got some incredibly talented people in our community who can do
just,
stuff like
just again, other stuff that will be included in the update besides like the obvious stuff like the wind turbine hydrogen engines. Roldobot asked what happened to... Roldobot asked... My
objective disappeared.
Oh, no. Whatever happened to flickering light fix, is it in? We will have more information with regards to bug fixes and optimizations once the actual update happens. But I know that the QA team has been going hard on a lot of bugs. And thank you to people who keep submitting bugs on our support site. It's greatly appreciated, so thank you.
That's weird.
Did
I fly past it? No, it would have. What do you reckon, Aragaf? Did it despawn? Because did I have a limited time? No, it's not behind me either. I might have overshot it. It's likely.
And just going back up.
Unless
here,
I did overshot it, because then it would have despawned.
About a Tacita 13, is there a possibility of working orbital mechanics?
Oh.
Again, it's something that we get asked quite often, and for this update, no. But we have lots of ideas. We have new blocks coming in to the game, and lots of other new features. So it's definitely something we've noticed on the support side, on social media. So been off for this update.
There it is. I found it. Sorry, guys. Yay. I had to cheat because I was too busy talking. But here we are. Welcome to the facility engineer. You're tasked to defend its beacon to the best of your ability. Prepare the facility against the attacks. Wave is in 4 minutes.
This is a fun question. Just Jakaya underscore official asked, if you could add any block to the game, what would it be? What would it be? Joel? Do you have one? I'm gonna kind of do like a cop out answer and say small block window, so I don't have to keep hearing about it. But I understand why. I understand why, because there are so many. I see so many practical applications for it. But I would say that. That's my answer.
I want to say wings.
Oh, okay.
But then it's like, it's not really a block. It kind of requires. I would say wings. But if it wasn't wings, I'd say small ship cockpit. Please, a small ship flight seat, please.
Yeah. That's a good choice. Good question, thank you. Actually, that brings up an interesting point though too, just while like Joel's playing. It's like, we realize that there are so many, like, we get so many cool ideas submitted to us, and it's, you know, it's never us thinking like, oh, like, you know, why would we do that? Or we don't have the time. We definitely keep track of all these things. And again, like there are lots of exciting things coming in Space Engineers this year and beyond. So please keep that in mind.
I'm just showcasing this. So this is, once you get to this, this is where you start off. And of course, the waves get harder and harder. Now you see here, we've got some defense already. We've got a fighter to fight them back with. We've got a generator that needs repairing. We've got a small turret that needs repairing and a large one. But I think, yet again, this is a really cool looking little asteroid base, and we've got 3 minutes to wait. So we'll wait for this first wave to see what happens, right?
Also, to just answering a question here from Dova Kin 45, any plans for more star systems to travel to? Again, it's one of those things that we can't really comment on right now. You know, all the ideas that we have internally, and then all the awesome ones we get from the community. All I'll say is that who knows what the future holds, perhaps.
Sorry, wait a minute.
Yeah, no worries. Okay, Glubfruend, again, if I'm mispronouncing your name, sorry. Rain on Earth, dust on Mars, perhaps. Again, certainly not for this update. You know, there is that wind turbine there, and somebody asked earlier, like, are we faking wind? You know, if by that you mean, are we adding those things you just asked? No, but is it a possibility in the future? Perhaps, yes. Oh, so many questions.
So, of course, I'm actually looking. I think tomorrow I'll play this on stream with some friends, because I'm curious to see how long we can survive.
I'm curious too, because like it's kind of like a classic scenario, like, you know, the endless wave scenario. But you know, I think what's really cool about this scenario is that in many endless wave scenarios, say like perhaps in like maybe Call of Duty or other games, you don't have the freedom of choice with regards to you know, what you build. You know, what base you go to and those sorts of things. Sometimes you do, but I think there's just what we really try to do is kind of try and keep the sandbox elements and the freedom of choice elements present in it, which is really cool. So yeah, I'm excited to see that.
Oh, hello, what's that? I saw a red target.
Timir underscore raw asks, can I join you tomorrow? Yeah, if you join Joel's stream, there might be room for you to join in.
See them. All right, 1 minute until 51 seconds, counting down by the second now. I'm scared. Okay, right. I'm gonna get to this ship here and try and fight them back.
I'm moving my knee. I'm just gonna move slightly.
Thank you. That's what I appreciate that kindness. Thought going into
battle.
When you're an MLG gamer, you know, you gotta have ultimate focus.
um,
So pretty cool looking fighter again. Another Aragaf, awesome thing here. A little compact. Not using the small batteries actually, using the large battery, but it's pretty cute. 16 seconds, where from?
Sorry guys, I know there's more questions. I'm just kind of getting ready for this wave because I'm really curious to see what it looks like.
4, 3, 2, 1. Here it comes. All right, it's going to start easy, okay? So the first wave, I've just got here, so it's just going to be, it looks like it's going to be one drone to start with. Wave one incoming, defend the facility. All right, let's have a little peek. Easy. You watch this. My turret's already firing at it. Hold on, is it more than one? No. What's my turret firing at then? There is another one. Oh no, I'm getting, hold on. All right, got him.
Well done.
No. They're retreating as well. They're backing up from me, I think.
Yeah.
Oh, this one's a bit bigger, hold up. Nice.
It's nice that there's that progression, I suppose. It would have been funny if he would have just been like, ah!
I got that aim.
20.
Oh no, I say easy. Look at my damage, look.
Oh.
I lost like the half of my, that side of my ship, so.
Still in the fight.
But that was like the first wave, right? And it's gonna get with increased complexity. So I think here we have, I can technically try and salvage this ship. Oh, what the heck? I'm getting shot from somewhere. No, I'm gone. See? I told you. Experienced player right here, you know, and I just got wrecked in the first wave. Right, come on, what are you doing down there, turret? I need to Alright. Alright.
Jackie official, can you
No!
Oh!
Too hard, Aragaf! Nerf this map. Oh man, I've lost my turret. Alright, we have to go in by hand, lads. Alright, let's get in, right. Alright, come here.
If he kills you.
This is the last resort. Alright. Come here. It's trying to avoid me. It doesn't want to be ground down. He's shooting me.
It's turning into not medieval engineers, but I didn't expect to see you defending the first wave with this.
No, I didn't either. I was kit out. I was absolutely sorted out, yeah.
Well, that's awesome.
Yeah.
Do you...
There we go. I got a rifle. What am I on about? But you know, I'm saving ammo, so I'm kidding.
Strategically.
I mean, obviously, I made a mistake though. I misjudged how many ships there were. But you can kind of see now what you can expect, guys. And I think it's going to be fun because what's nice about something like this is that you can actually approach it in different methods, right? Do you want to build a whole like kind of array of turrets out away from the base? Do you want to just focus on building a ship? Do you want to focus on like self-made missiles? Do you want, there's so many different ways that you can play this. I think it's great because I think it kind of has an emphasis on the engineering side of space engineers. It's a scenario.
Whilst incorporating combat, which is kind of cool. Pretty neat. Do you plan it? Jakai official, do you plan to expand upon progression system and link it to exploration? As far as, you know, how the actual, like, you know, just, you know, starting out a survival scenario in space engineers, obviously I think that's kind of already there as far as, you know, establishing your base and then exploring more. With regards to that specifically, I actually, as of right now, I don't know. But again, like I said, please message me so I can put all these questions down into a Google Doc and I can ask the right people and get back to you. Like, happy to do it, so.
I wanted to add that, I've gone blank. Again with the visual scripting tool. So for example, you see this visual scripting tool scenario in use, so you can make an identical scenario, and maybe even you could actually copy and paste the scenario, but change the base up, right? Make it easier or harder. So you could, I think you yourselves could actually make a wave survival map with different elements. Oh, here we go, different elements. Oh, that's the same one I got, I think. It's still trying to get me here, but it's got no weapon anymore. It's kind of...
I saw a good question.
Aragaf, how many enemies do you have in this? Because I went through the prefab list, and there's quite a lot that Aragaf's made for this update. I mean, what I could do is here, I could try and paste him on the explorate one of the I was tempted to paste in one of the encounters, but I feel like I'll leave all the encounters for you guys to find, because actually it's quite fun to actually come across an encounter, and some of you guys will be coming across the encounters for the first time. Like, no one's ever found it before. So there could almost be like, if you find something really cool, for example, you could post it on in the Discord or Reddit and be like, hey, damn, I was the first person to find this encounter or something like that, right? Like, there's a whole bunch out there and it's gonna take a while for them all to be found, I think. So we are still tweaking it. The drones need to be destroyed. Okay, I need to finish this. Hold on. Right. It's not dead yet. It is not dead yet, but I assumed I... Okay, hold on. Where's that? Where's he gone? He's hiding from me, I think.
Okay. He's going to try and ambush you.
Look where he went. I should have finished him while I had him. There it is. He's running now.
Rivion says keep an eye on your oxygen.
Yeah, well done. Thank you, Riv. Right, there we go. Destroyed. Wave two in... Well, wave coming in 2 minutes.
Lord Beacon asks, where does the generator on the ship get its fuel from? I don't see a hydrogen tank. That might be a question for...
Oh, good. I can repair. I can actually heal up at this. So again, once you first arrive at this base, you have to do some repairs. So I actually had to take the components out of this and fix up these things here. Let's see. There we go.
Sorry, I got sidetracked there for a second.
It's all right.
Chris asked, do you have an idea of space engineers' development time? Like, if by that do you mean, like, for instance, like, when the update's coming out or when we're coming out of early access.
Right.
We don't have official dates for either of those things right now. We're just really focused right now on running these public tests, getting as much feedback as possible as we can from you guys, and then going from there. So that's where we're at right now with development.
A couple of things I just suddenly thought about. You won't be able to use the wind turbines in space, and you won't be able to use them on ships either. I forgot how big it is. Damn.
Well, that makes sense.
Yeah. So you won't be able to have like self-powered ships with wind power or anything like that.
Yeah.
So there has to be on a static grid for that to work.
Any other? This is an interesting question. Snow Raider 8 asks, Keen Community Network, Warframe has community created content they regularly add into the game based on popular vote. Are there any considerations to do something like that with encounters? Just based on how like the general, like, you know, for instance, how the support site works and just how we generally gather feedback from social media, I would like officially as of right now, no, but as far as like, could it be something that we consider in the future? Yeah, absolutely. Just because, you know, we really do think that the feedback we get from you guys helps us make better games. And, you know, we can't always add everything, obviously all at once, but yeah, maybe.
All right, I'm going to defend this wave with my ship. Here they come.
Oh.
We got a Mark IIs. Ooh. They're blue drones this time. Oh. Sniped.
Oof.
Damn. Absolutely sniped. Oh, this is it. It didn't even get to ram there. Whoa!
That was a snipe ball.
I'm doing a really bad example of this, guys.
A very good one, depending on how you.
I think you're all gonna have you're all gonna have a better chance of surviving than me. You can tell, basically what happens is, it gets to a certain point and it blows up, I think. I'm not sure if that's scripted or if that's a warhead, but basically it gets to a certain damage level and then it gets destroyed, so. This is a tougher one here, look at that. It's a bit tougher. I'm firing rapid fire into it. And I'm out of ammo, so.
Jakai Official, could P-Gravity be added to asteroids but at very low values, or is there a technical reason why not? Again, I actually don't know, but again, please submit to us on a support site, and then I'm always happy to forward it to the space guys. And they actually, you know what, whether it's like a server issue or a question like that, like I usually get an answer from them, you know, the same day or at the very least like the next day. So please message me on Discord or the support site.
Oh, it's hot.
Yeah, I was just gonna say.
Okay, so I think nearly the things I wanted to mainly go through for the test tomorrow.
Seeing more, a few questions here, maybe.
I'll look at the blog post and to remind if there's anything I wanted to talk about.
Yeah, go for it. Okay, so many. Obnoxious faux life. Can you give me an error? Are the LCDs functional on the cockpits? As far as if like they're going to display like, you know, information with regards to like, say, incoming hostile, like, you know, rockets or something like that. No, they're not. Thanks for posting the blog post in the chat, Gwendolmere.
Yeah, that's the one we're looking at now, so you can see that. If you want to go over and see basically what we're reading from. The main purpose of the tonight stream was to kind of just emphasize what we want you guys to test in the update, right?
Also too, like I know there's some people we haven't answered your question again, we apologize, and please send them to us, and we'll do our best to get back to you as soon as possible. Yeah, I think, I mean, as did you see anything in the blog post that pardon me?
I'm looking.
And thank you, Gwendolmere, for putting the support website in the chat. I will spam it as well.
Oh yeah, we'll go back to the planet and I'll show you some...
Good question quickly. Cosmic Chimp asked, how many servers will there be there tomorrow? As of right now, one for the US, one for the EU, but we're probably going to have some more. And the reason why we wanted to start it, we always struggle with what days to put the public tests on and what time, but the reason we're starting earlier our time is just so we can kind of hopefully ease into it with regards to the amount of players that join, and then adjust from there as far as, you know, possibly adding more servers or keeping the ones that we have right now. So sorry, we want to say something, Joel?
No, I just wanted to show off more of the folios.
Oh yeah, no, it looks I mean, I'm biased because it's, you know, we work on this game, but it looks really nice.
Just it's so much better seeing some diversity in the actual foliage now,
because before it was kind of like I mean, at times I thought of, like, you know, Mario trees, you know, like the real, but this looks really cool.
Let me see if I can find. I'm trying to think if there's new.
This is like the very first place, the very first time I ever played Survival. I landed here, which actually kind of sucked. I wasn't near.
Sorry, I see there's a question here that's been repeated. Welcome to everyone who's joining us, guys. It's great to see you all.
Yeah, there's just so many.
I know.
Which is awesome. Like, keep them coming. And, you know, and please, that also reminds me, too, like, with regards to the feedback, be candid. Include as much as you can for us, because, like, the Space Engineers team just, like, eats that stuff up and loves it, because it really does help us make improvements. So, please.
Dr. and Kev asks, what about balancing the uranium spawn?
Oh, yeah.
Reactor
Sorry.
Build I saw cost, that. Since we have a lower tier hydrogen generator now. I'm not sure how it's been changed and balanced, but I believe it has been, Dr. Dragon Kev. It's another question, it's another detail for Aragaf. Uranium definitely is higher end now, because you have more lower tier things, mid tier things. But it's, yeah, as to how it's changed, I'm not entirely sure. Yeah, I think all resources have been rebalanced, because of course some resources are required for the survival kit.
Survival kit, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Like, they're essential.
Yeah, you need them.
And
<Sure.
laughs> other ones aren't so essential until you start building stuff like the reactor components.
Yeah, more and more advanced blocks.
The things with jump drives, right?
This is an interesting one too. 31 manual, what are your thoughts on better AI you can build to automate boring tasks like mining, welding, and grinding? There are already tons of mods that try to address this issue. It's kind of a twofold question. Again, that's a really cool idea, and something that could definitely end up in the game in the future. For this update, no. But also too, just like we It's so cool how like the sheer amount, like the quantity and quality of like the mods that, you know, the space engineers community comes out with. And they definitely inspire us, that like for sure. So
So Gwyn said that apparently there's no longer uranium on planets.
Really?
So that is one of the balances. You will not find uranium on planets, which of course means that until you get to space, you won't be able to get uranium.
That's interesting.
So that you'll be relying on let's say cleaner, but you know, wind power and the hydrogen as well.
Chikai official, why is there a fir tree in the desert? Who do I defer that one to? Art?
Design? All those monkeres.
kill the yellow, stockpile the uranium. Mine it and sell it. No.
Easy 1 hour stream.
Yeah, exactly.
Joe Astu, Jesse is a community manager and he is responsible for replying to everything pretty much. You'll see him on Reddit, you'll see him on Twitter, Facebook, YouTube, email. He is the reply guy. Well, that makes it sound like it's not so, but it...
the cool thing is like, you know, I really do, I mean, I obviously, especially when it comes to like, for instance, like a platform like YouTube, I definitely can't answer every single comment because there's so many. But I, even if we don't answer them, we read most of them. And, you know, it also to like, you know, shout out to the people that, you know, I see posting issues about a bug, say that they're experiencing on YouTube, and then I suggest please submit to the support site, and they do it. Awesome. Or even, you know, and the jokes. It's awesome when you're going through all those YouTube comments, the jokes. Please keep them coming. So
keep up the memes.
Yeah, exactly.
Hold on a minute. I was trying to get something out. Philcon, welcome. Philcon's one of the programmers at Keen Software House, and he helped implement a lot of this stuff. I forgot his exact role, but he definitely obviously helped with this. And I also saw Inflect as well. So I see a number of our programmers in the chat tonight, and I mean, they might have some more details and information. So if you want to ask some programming relating things, then that could be a good idea.
Also shout out to Philcon, if you're ever asking about a server issue, and then relaying it to me, he is awesome for getting back to me quickly and then allowing me to get back to people quickly. So thank you. It's not just me helping answer questions. The guys who are actually like working on the game day in and day out, and ladies for that matter, they do help me a lot. So, you know, thanks to them. It's awesome. Helps.
Finally got this done. I was trying to freaking.
Ooh. It's just like the teaser, only in game.
Oh, I just deleted it. All right.
Oh.
No, this, to do it properly, what you need is... Oh, no, I was going to do wheel. Ah, I'll do. All right, hold on. Then what you want is you want to throw down some wheels.
As far as Krillnire asks, how does the mill work high and low input? I actually, if I'm being honest, I do not know. Perhaps we can get it going here, if you mean wind turbine.
Inventory full.
Inventory. Run down the wheels. And you got yourself a nice little
Hey.
Wind, it can also be painted, so you can paint whatever color you like. Let's go for a yellow, so there we go.
Ooh. Yeah. Looks cool. When can we edit voxels in survival? I thought this was meant to be part of survival update. I'm not entirely sure. Please send that question to me and I will forward it to the devs. Do wind farms spin at day and night? Presumably?
Yes.
I believe so.
They do.
Yeah, they should.
Yeah, we should probably wrap it up.
Yeah,
soon.
I was just gonna say, this is fun. Like this is awesome, guys, and like, you know, thank you like, you know, to everyone that that tuned in, and apologies for the audio issues at the beginning. I think we can safely say we're improving. If anybody tunes into us on a regular basis, our streams are as far as the technical difficulties, we're not experiencing nearly as many at all.
We sorted the stream out, which is good.
Which is awesome.
So I hope you guys are excited, because literally, what is it? We said already, like, now it's even less. Now it's like...
Oh, more math.
14 and a half hours.
Yes.
You'll be able to play this yourselves And you'll be able to find all the little things, because there's more we've changed. The chat, we changed chat, haven't we? Let me see. Ah, yes. So look, we have global chat now. Wait, I'm trying to remember. Actually, trying to remember here.
Oh, you do good bot?
No. But
oh, global, pardon me. Sorry.
We did, that is new, right? We changed chat.
We did. No, it is. It's in the bot. Yep. Again, it's not just, you know, we're trying to show off things like, again, the hydrogen engine, the wind turbine, you know, small batteries, LCD, survival kit, all that stuff. But there's lots of other stuff like PCU changes, chat, visual scripter, you know, various performance tweaks here and there, voxel textures, you know, there's lots of things. And we have to like emphasize again that just because something is not included in this survival update doesn't mean that we won't be adding more to the game in the future. It's an ongoing process. And again, we just wanted to showcase like what you can do in the public test tomorrow and future public tests. We're gonna have two more after this for sure. And also too, with regards to just kind of trying to clarify some of the things in Marek's post.
I think there's just showing that you can whisper now. I can't think this is new. The thing is, because obviously we've had some of these things behind scenes for a while.
Yeah,
so I can't think
it's hard to remember because you're like,
new
we've
and what's like not there. Yeah, is this new, guys? Is it new? I don't know. Or is it just changed? We just tweaked it. I can't remember. I think maybe we made it smaller. It takes up less room now. So Inflex has got some deets for us that the wind turbine maxes out at around 360 kilowatt hours on Earth.
Oh, interesting. Okay.
That's some actual facts from the code, I guess, at the output of that.
Oh, this is a good question. Jaden Irise, how do we launch the public test? I will be updating the post. I will not only be updating the post that I said sent out today with regards to the public test on the actual branch code / password, but also how you actually input it into Steam. And I will have a separate post on that as well. So there will be instructions tomorrow.
I think.
Is there anything else you wanted to?
The main thing was about covering things in the update.
Yes.
To test, right?
Yeah.
We play the new scenarios briefly. So definitely, please, guys, play the scenarios because this is something that it's the first thing you see when you load the game. So it's the thing that needs to be kind of like tested most. So you can have some fun either in the survival, kind of discovering what's in the map, or the survive the horde kind of thing and find out if there's anything there, because we want to get all the bugs from that.
And if you just try as many of the new features as you can. Obviously, we all know that some players gravitate towards certain things as opposed to others, but yeah, like, the more feedback we can get, the better. Thank you in advance. And also too, I will be posting about another King community stream. This guy will be streaming tomorrow, possibly in the afternoon, the evening, on his channel. So I'll be sure to include it, as well as Robin Shield, possibly Epic Tech, and Cosmic Chimp. So they'll also be going through this in great detail for, you know, anywhere between 3 and 5 hours.
Yeah,
so.
Depending on my work, I might see if I can start streaming like in the late afternoon, like 5 o'clock. But normally I'd go home, of course. But I'm thinking maybe because then we can just start testing and start playing with people on a server, because there will be the servers up. And it's going to be how these respawning systems and how all this works in the actual kind of multiplayer sense, especially. So
yeah, it should be pretty cool.
I was going to quickly, I guess, because some of you guys joined us late, right? So apologies if you joined us late and you might have missed some things, but
I'm putting the link to Marek's blog again in the chat for people who are just joining us. If you want to go check that out, it's also available on all of our social media, Reddit, YouTube, Twitter, Facebook, etc. Also, too, as always, the link to our support website.
Awesome at the mod SDK. I'm not sure. Do we have any of our resident modders or?
Sectan was here earlier. I noticed some other.
I'm not sure. Yeah, that's a good question. Actually, a backup. There's something we haven't shown off yet. I know we haven't shown off something. We haven't shown off the moon. I just want to show briefly because we have these. Yeah, Jimical, what's up, man? Do you know if the mod SDK's changed much, Jim?
Can we get crude oil engines?
So the only thing we haven't checked, obviously the different spawns, but all of these are like the standard drop pods. And then the space is this one. But the moon has its own special one. And the moon is the only one, Titan, but also the moon is a hard one. In low gravity, you can see the oxygen level, and it's also, you have this wheel thing. So this, it kind of just drops in, actually. It's not actually a parachute, but you basically load in, and this is your moving vehicle. It's basically like the drop pod with wheels almost. So you see, you know, you've got the survival kit on the back, but it's quite cute. You can move around the lunar surface and get to work. But this is a harder start because it's just the matter of the fact you can't breathe, right? So all the rest of it. I can hit one, Aragath said. Oh, I can, oh damn. You can do little jumps as well. Oh. So Aragath has included a little hydrogen thruster on the
bottom.
That's
pretty cool.
I doubt that'll let me get to space. It's probably not gonna be enough hydrogen to get to space, but I mean, the moon's quite, you know, it's the gravity is much lower here, but I still don't think it's gonna be. Oh, to get out of okay. So it's to get out of craters, because as you guys know, hold on, let's go into one by purpose. I mean, it's probably happened to me. But of course, like this thing can't do so much. So if I go, oh, I'm too busy, oh, I'm going down, and then this is the kind of situation where your vehicle will not be able to drive out of, probably. We'll try.
I'm very doubtful.
So, it's gonna be a tough one. So what I can do is smack on the old hydrogen. There we go. I guess tilt forward a bit because there's only one. It's only got one, so you kind of have to like fly like a helicopter and then turn off. There we go. Free of the crater, and we can land safely and boom on the journey. So I think the moon is going to be a fun start.
Yeah,
it's going to be. I think again, especially for like more experienced players, just to get have that.
Kenkin 224 says beautiful singing. I agree. That's actually, funny story. I may or may not have been working on good.bot for the last release, and it was a bit of a later night, full day doing the community management stuff, and I was just helping to try and get that finalized. And I took off my headphones, and this guy, I don't know if you were singing Michael Jackson or Prince or what, but it sounded good. I just took off my headphones, and it was like a own little karaoke thing going
Jesse
on.
Jesse was listening into my late night shenanigans.
It was good.
My private times in the
awesome.
Office. I assume there's no one around, but
can add that as
sing right now. Sounds exactly. But why the atmo thrusters? Oh, I think the atmo thrusters, it's a good point actually, because they're on the standard pod, but I'm not quite sure why they're on this build as well.
They're cool.
I mean, maybe for like the free parts to grind down.
Yeah,
extra components, right? And the good news is like people, I think, obviously the sharing of information, people have played a bit more, and also in Discord, I think people will be able to help each other now and understand what's going on a bit better. I'll be able to talk about things now, because obviously it's been a killer trying to not talk about some of the things and how they work and so on. So it's nice to be able to just go ahead and talk about and explain everything to the best that I know. So, oh, it's got a, no, this one doesn't have a parachute actually. This one is missing a parachute.
Oh, yeah.
Because it just spawns above the planet's surface. So. All right then.
Okay. Well, yeah, I guess like on that note, like thanks again for everybody for tuning in and for all the questions. Just looking at my looking at my Discord, I have a lot of questions that have been DM'd to me, and I'm sure.
Is there any really important ones that I know that we can get? Because obviously we could probably be answering questions. I mean, I always know this. You can be answering questions all night, but
yeah, exactly.
Is there any more ones that would be really kind of helpful for people going into this?
Trying to see.
Hello. Uh oh.
Okay. Well, I mean.
Uh-oh.
Thanks, Captain Jack.
Oh!
Good luck.
Somebody, oh, man, this is going to be fun. This is.
Somebody asked about nutrition.
It's like Flappy Bird.
Yeah.
Not Flappy Bird.
Angry Birds.
No. Flappy Bird, the one where you like go up and down the craters like this.
Oh, yeah, I think that is Flappy Bird. Somebody asked about nutrition, and I've heard a lot of people asking about like food and possible other survival additions. Again, not for this update, but again, just because it's not in this update doesn't mean that we're not considering implementing the game in the future. So yeah, please, and many of those like certainly food and survival nutrition, they're on our support site, and again I'll link it in chat after. You can see all the ideas that are submitted by the community, and you can vote on them, you can comment on them, and our devs are looking at that when they have spare time. They aren't always able to comment on them right away, but they do look at them. So okay, maybe like one more here. 40 good names. Do you have any plans to add more NPC slash animals, aliens, robots, etc.? Again, it's not in this. It's not in this update, but we 2019 is going to be a good year for space engineers, and I think last year was an awesome year. And there are lots of ideas that we have, and lots of ideas that we have been inspired by from the community messaging us. So we'll see.
Compose, I guess. Yeah.
Yeah, I'm trying to think if there's any other good ones. Just like right now. Okay. Last few.
It's like, yeah. Look, guys, I don't know what people think I crash. Like, there's literally no evidence on the internet of me crashing, all right? So, you know, I am...
No, Smokey. Hi, by the way. It's always nice to chat with you on Reddit. You said, and I thought you were more or less done with SE. Absolutely not. There are lots more things coming to the game. Where... Of course, we're privy to stuff that we can't share right now, but we're really excited, especially about the survival public test. Again, just it's plastered all over our social media, but it starts tomorrow at 10 a.m. UTC. It goes until Friday at 4 p.m. UTC. It could be extended. We're going to have more tests, and we thank you in advance for all the feedback. And I guess I'll just say like a personal thanks for having me on the stream. Finally, I've been in the chat trying to field questions and help with Medieval Engineers Tournament. But thank you.
Jesse's done a marvelous job of standing in for Marek, who's currently away on travels. Because I'm used to on these streams focusing on the game and trying. Cause I'm not amazing at multitasking, but I think Jesse's done a great job of answering questions. So I hope you guys. Had a good time tonight, and we will be going through this much more.
Yes.
Tomorrow, you guys will have it. There'll be people streaming it. I'll be streaming it. Please do send all your stuff in and get the feedback in. There is this thing that will actually let you know exactly what is... at the end there'll be this...
The survey.
Survey.
Yeah. Exactly. And also, too, just to iterate, too, please do not hesitate to DM me on Discord if you have any problems like accessing the test, or if you're, just have any questions in general. I try and get back to people as quickly as possible. And yeah, thanks again for tuning in.
All right, guys, says, remember, guys, there is still lots left to tweak, and your feedback is vital. It's true.
Yes.
When it comes to the actual balance, like it's sometimes really hard to get it right. Like, should uranium be this and there and this amount? And Aragaf has been doing lots of tweaks, like even on a week-to-week basis. So I really, it's really important that now you guys are playing it, we can quickly find out what is working and what is not working.
Yes.
So yeah.
It's greatly appreciated. And yeah.
The trailer will be, because that's what I've been busy on.
Yes.
The trailer will be when the update formally releases. Because you guys are like early birds right now, like having this testing thing. Looking at what we've been working on, but when we actually formally release the update, that's when you'll see a trailer. So,
and the trailer, as always, will be epic.
Don't put that pressure on me.
Man, it's just true though, because I've been helping with the trailer in my own little way, and it's a team effort. But this guy, at the end of the day, puts it all together, and yeah, it's gonna be cool. It's gonna be very cool.
So I was hoping to get a good end shot here before we. To kind of end this on, but I guess, it's always important.
You can go back to this is cool. I mean, the menu.
Well, this is not this isn't there.
Oh,
yet.
That's true.
This is not true. This is just my game. This is not there yet. This
apologies.
Yet, because,
again, it's one of those instances where it's like we've had access.
Well, what can I load up here? Which is I'll just load up this. It has some blocks in the background. So, dad jokes. Yeah, I can sort you out. I've got all the dad jokes. Cringe quote. Yeah, maybe I can cook something up. So what time is it now? Yeah, I will go home now, but I'm going to do a stream tonight as well, but not the new update yet. But if you got more questions and stuff, then maybe I can try and address some of that tonight anyway, but you'll find out for yourself when you get a hold of it in a bit. So that's what's going to happen now. Jesse's going to go home, get some well-deserved rest.
Yes. And again, thanks for tuning in, guys, and we hope to see as many of you as possible for the public test, which starts tomorrow.
Yes.
And yeah, take care.
Yeah, thank you guys, thank you so much. Oh, hold on. Oh god. Okay, but that's all for now. If you're interested in the full list of things in this thing to test, check out Marek's blog. Thanks for watching. I'll see you all in about half an hour when I get home. And as always...
the cringe. Remember to put your helmet on in non-oxygenated environment. I
If you're excited to test the new blocks, be sure to keep an eye on the clock. Because it's coming tomorrow, like 11 a.m. Okay.
See you guys.